Did you know that threat actors are utilizing tools to map your subscriptions and resources to identify which resources are not secure? That's right. And we now have the Azure Defender for Azure Resource Manager that will allow you to have visibility and identify if a threat actor is trying to do that. You're going to see all that on today's episode, and you also see Azure Defender for Azure DNS. Stay right there. Be right back. Welcome everyone to episode 13. And today we have someone that's been here before. Actually, the first episode of Azure Security Center in the Field was recorded by this guy. So it's a pleasure to have him back to talk about a very recent announcement that we had in Azure Security Center. So without further ado, Tal Rosler, welcome back, my friend.
Thank you, Yuri. Glad to be here. Thanks for inviting
Absolutely. Me. Always a pleasure to talk to you about threat detection. And today, we're going to talk about a recent announcement that we had around Azure Defender for Azure Resource Manager, ARM, and Azure DNS. And I know that you were deeply involved on this, so congratulations for this major milestone, first of all. And let's talk about what it is, what that we are actually looking at as far as threat detection. Can you explain a little bit how it works?
Sure. So first, I will use my slide for this question. Okay. So generally speaking, what we had until now in Azure Security Center called Death Threat Protection. Actually, we are protected each kind of popular Azure workload against threats. So for example, we have an offering to protect Azure virtual machines against threats, SQL servers, web apps, and et cetera. And we kind of looking on a specific workload in Azure and giving a holistic threat protection for this workload. What we are entering now with our new offering to Azure Defender called a Breadth Threat Protection. It's actually protecting not specific workloads, but protecting the entire environment, the entire Azure environment, by protecting specific layers that are connected to all of the resources in the Azure workload. So for example, we have offering protecting the Azure network that's connected to most of the Azure resources, and thus giving a breadth protection for all of the resources. We're protecting the key vault that's storing the keys and secrets of a lot of resources, and thus protecting, again, the resources that's connected to it. And now we're entering two new offerings called Azure Defender for DNS and Azure Defender for Resource Manager that are giving another layer of protection.
Awesome. Thanks for sharing these slides. That's very comprehensive. And so let's start with some more information about the Azure Resource Manager threat detection, or Azure Defender for ARM, better saying. Is there any additional information that we collect in order to generate those alerts, or everything we need is already collected and we are just adding the analytics on top of that?
Sure. So let me elaborate a bit about Azure Defender for Resource Manager. What we're doing in Azure Defender for Resource Manager, we're actually looking on all resource management operations that's done in your environment. For example, if someone creating resources in the Azure portal, in the Azure REST APIs, via PowerShell, for example, and manage the Azure resources, we're looking at all of these operations in your Azure environment. We're analyzing all the operations that's done in your environment and trying to detect threats to your environment. So we're actually trying to detect, for example, someone trying to steal conditionals of any of your user accounts in the environment and try to perform suspicious or malicious operations in his behalf. So this is one of our main protections, and we're trying to look for suspicious actions user doing in the Azure Resource Manager and alert when this kind of happen. So for your question, we're using the the Azure Resource Manager logs and operations, and analyzing them to detect threats and alert you when something.
So there is nothing really new that we are collecting. Things are already there. We are just building analytics on top of that, basically.
Yeah, so actually we are monitoring the Azure activity logs. It's the first time we are doing this in Security Center and try to detect threats based on the Azure activity logs. And in addition, we are using internal logs of the mm-hmm. Azure platforms that's not available for customers. They're used only by us. And with these logs as well, we're trying to understand what happened in the Azure environment and detect threats better.
Can you give me some examples of threats that Azure Defender for ARM is capable of identifying?
Sure. So generally speaking, we have three kind of families of threats we are detecting. So first, we're detecting suspicious operations done in the Azure environment. For example, disablement of protection tools. So someone tried to disable protection tools in our Azure environment, or we're detecting them and alerting when this happened. And another example is using highly privileged operations to harm your organization. So one example could be using of VM extensions via the control plane of Azure and try, for example, to run a malicious script on your Azure workloads via the Azure Resource Manager. So this kind of suspicious operations that's done via the Azure Resource Manager that we are detecting. Second family is suspicious users. So we're trying to detect when some of the user accounts in your organizations are connected from suspicious, for example, suspicious IP addresses or suspicious locations. And this could imply that their user have been compromised and using the conditionals for malicious purposes. And the third family and third bucket, it's usage of exploitation mm-hmm. toolkits to exploit the Azure environment. So in the web, there is a lot of open source toolkits to exploit the Azure environment. Some more familiar with the Microburst toolkits and the PowerAzure. So we're trying to detect when someone using these toolkits against your environment and alert you when this happens.
That's great. That's a very interesting scenario. And I'm guessing that these scenarios are more scenarios for public preview. I'm pretty sure that we are always planning to expand those scenarios by GA, right?
Sure, yeah. It's only the tip of the iceberg that we started with. And for GA, we are planning to add a lot of more context and to detect a lot of threats. For example, stuff that we are looking for, it's a suspicious permission change in your environment or network change.
Awesome.
Stuff like
awesome.
This.
Now let's switch to Azure Defender for DNS, because this is a very interesting topic. I was actually reading a recent report from IDC that shows that in 2020, 79% of the organizations that were surveyed on this study were victims of DNS type of attack. So what are the scenarios that we are covering with this new Azure Defender for DNS offering?
Yeah, sure. So let me give you a brief explanation about the Azure Defender for DNS. So in Azure Defender for DNS, we again looking on all the Azure resources in your environment that connected to the Azure DNS. Azure DNS is the main DNS servers of Azure. And we're actually monitoring all the DNS queries that your resourcing is doing and try to detect threats based on these queries. So by doing so, we actually protecting the variety of Azure resources that's connected to this layer. And what we are trying to detect is actually divided to two categories. One is DNS attacks, attacks that are using the DNS mechanism. For example, DNS tunneling is such an attack. DNS tunneling is trying to exfiltrate data from your Azure resources, sensitive data, and stall it by the DNS mechanism. And another kind of attack is a DNS cache poisoning, when an attacker try to redirect your communication to a malicious mm-hmm. Website, for example. These kind of attacks utilizing the DNS mechanism to attack the resource. And then another kind of attacks are actually compromised resources that try to communicate with a malicious domain. So for example, we know to detect communications with Bitcoin mining domains, with phishing related domains, dark web, and stuff like
Great.
This.
Great. And I understand the name is Azure for DNS, the name of the server, the services in Azure. But is it only the PaaS service, Azure DNS, or do we also monitor the DNS that is running a VM, which is located in Azure, which is more like an IIS scenario rather than a PaaS scenario?
So the Azure Defender for DNS currently only protecting the Azure DNS. When a resource created in Azure, it's by default connected to the Azure DNS. So a lot of resources in Azure are connected to the Azure DNS, and we're detecting threat in this layer. By doing so, actually, our offering is agentless. We don't requiring to install any agent on the machine. You just in few button of clicks. Turning on Azure Defender for DNS, and we're actually querying the DNS queries from the internal Azure servers, and then and we know to detect threats on our machines. So this is the advantage of not installing any agent and using the PaaS offering.
Sure, makes sense. Now let's switch a little bit to some of the demonstrations, and you can demonstrate both capabilities, both alerts, and give some explanation, okay?
Cool. So first, I will demo how to turn on Azure Defender for DNS and Azure Defender for Resource Manager, and then I will move to the alerts that we are generating. So here I am in the main page of Azure Security Center. From here, to turn on Azure Defender for DNS and Azure Defender for Resource Manager, I'm going to the pricing and setting page, subscriptions. And here in the list of Azure Defender plans, we can see that we have two new plans now, the Azure Defender for Resource Manager and the Azure Defender for DNS that are in preview. Just click on both of the offering, save this. And from now on, I am protected. You don't, as I said, our new offerings are agentless. You don't need to protect to install any software on your machine. You just turn it on and you are protected. So this is how you are enabling Azure Defender for Resource Manager for DNS on your subscriptions. And once you enabled, you are protected. And every time we will detect threats on your resources, we will raise a security alert for you. So I'm going back to the main page of Azure Security Center. And now I will demo how to see the alerts that are generated by Azure Defender for DNS and Resource Manager. So for this, I will go to security alerts. So this is the main page that presents all security alerts of Azure Defender. And here you can see the alerts of Azure Defender for Resource Manager and the Azure Defender for DNS. So let me take an alert, for example. So I'm clicking here on the alert. And you can see an alert of Azure Defender for Resource Manager telling you that someone used microburst exploitation toolkits to exploit your Azure environment and extract keys, secret keys, from your Azure account, from a storage account. Sorry. So by clicking here to view full details, I can actually see all the details of the alert, what exactly happened. I can read here the description. Here I can see what the exact stage of the attack that this alert detected. Here in the alert details page, I can see all details that's needed for investigation. For example, what is the IP address that the attacker used to exploit your storage account here, and all the details you need to investigate this case. After I investigated and understood the detail, I can click next and go to the take action section. And here I can see detailed remediation steps on how I should respond to this threat and how should I mitigate the attack. So this is for Azure Defender for Resource Manager. And I will show you similar alerts from Azure Defender for DNS. So let me look for So this is an example of alert that Azure Defender for DNS could generate when it discovers threat in your environment. So here in this example, Azure Defender for DNS discovered possible data exfiltration from Azure resources using DNS tunneling. So I will click the view full details. And here again, you can see all the details of what happened, what the domain name this was querying to exfilt the data from a resource. And by going to the take action, you can actually see what we are recommending you to do in order to mitigate this threat. So this is it. If Yuri, do you have any question?
No, I think it's very comprehensive. And just to highlight the new Secure Alert Dashboard as well, very nice. Another very job well done. I know that you also were extremely involved on this new dashboard, so is another major milestone for Secure Center.
Yeah, I totally agree.
All right. So,
thank you.
Great demo. Thanks for taking the time to put it together. Do you have any final considerations that you want to share with our audience around those two new threat detections?
So I think our new offering is a kind of a new pillar in Azure Security Center, giving you protection on all of your Azure resources connected to these layers. So it's kind of comprehensive offering to the depth offering we have for every specific Azure workload, and it's giving you an umbrella of protection to all of your environment. So we are recommending to turn them on both together, and they should be complementary to each other.
And also, since we are still in preview, this is going to be free for during preview, right?
Yeah, that's correct. Our offering is entirely free during preview. You can turn it on free, and once we will getting closer to the general availability, we'll share the price with all the customers, and we will let you know in advance before we are building anything.
Excellent. So this is a great opportunity for you all to test those new services, Azure Defender for DNS, Azure Defender for ARM, validate your scenarios. It's fully documented. I'm going to put here the link for the documentation for both new threat detections. Make sure to test and provide feedback. If you receive an alert and that alert is not very comprehensive, we have a feedback form right there on the alert that you can provide feedback. And that also the user voice always available for you to provide feedback. So with that, it's another wrap for Azure Security Center in the field. Thanks again, Tal, for your time.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Anytime that you have something new to share, I'll be glad to have you on the show again. So you are always welcome. And for everyone watching, thank you very much for your audience. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. Please share the link. Please subscribe to make sure that you are receiving notifications when we upload new videos on the Microsoft Secure channel. Okay. And that's it for today. See you next time.